Hey, little piggies. Hey, guys. Hey, little pigs. How's everybody?
Where's Reese Bear?
Hey, little baby bear.
Hi, sweetie.
Gotta give you your pain med.
There you go.
Good girl. Now, does everybody want a snack? You guys want your treat? If I can open it, it's childproof. There you go. There you go. Half for you, baby. There you go, Annie. There you go, Hucky. I gotta get yours wet, Felvy. And Reese. So it's easier to eat. Here you go. And now where's my little Buzz? Buzz. Here, Buzzy. There you go, buddy. Good boy. Did you drop yours, baby? You can have another one. Who knows where that went? So everybody got the vitamin C. One of these has 25 milligrams. Baby or Veda, I give half. And Annie, I give half. And Busby, I give half. Everybody else gets a whole. Busby takes forever to eat one. Annie, if I give her more than that, I find it bugs her tummy. She actually gets a bit bloated. So I'm not sure what's in here that's a bit too much for her. And then baby, since she's a bit smaller, I just give her half. So I let them munch on that, and then I have to check Reese's abscess area to tidy it up. And then we'll get to tidying up the cage.
Okay, Reese Bear.
Come here. I can hardly reach. Hey, I'm gonna get you one way or another. Up we go. So I made a velvet loose for a little treat. Here, sweetie. Here you go. Okay. So, Reese Bear, I need to check her neck and see how it's doing. So I always put some saline on a little pad here, and I wet where the little scab is, get any discharge out, and then we flush it with some betadine. So I've got her discharge out. Now this is the betadine, and I'm adding it to a little dish here. And I fill up the syringe that has a cannula tip on it. And I flush out using, she has a little hole, flush out the inside of her little abscess pocket. It's very small. And just make sure it's clean. Up we go. There we go. Now I gotta go wash my hands and we'll be back. Alright, we ready for cleaning. Are you ready, baby? Hi, baby Riggy. Can we get cleaning over here? What's it? Nothing to snack on. Alright. So now I just have to spot clean everything. Tidy up their hay, change any little bed pads that need to be changed, which I think both of these do. So I spot clean twice a day, every morning, every night. I do full cage cleans twice a week on Mondays and Fridays. So usually, say if the morning this is the way the pad is, at night I flip it. And then the next morning, this gets changed. Same for their pads, for their hay. Use one side, use the other side, and then it gets changed. Just so I keep everything nice and dry and clean, so that nobody would get sore feet if it's getting too wet. So since I use fleece, it's a layer of fleece, and then sewn in between is two layers of U-Haul. So U-Haul is like a furniture moving blanket that's recycled denim that is really absorbent. So any pee goes on top and gets sucked right in down into the absorbent layer, and the top fleece stays dry. The only time the top fleece wouldn't feel dry is if it's way too wet, like they've peed a ton. But that doesn't happen very often, unless of course it's a main area where they're peeing a lot, like where their hay is. So that's why I change that all the time. Alright. So this is the messiest part. So you have orchard grass in the hay boxes, and then the rest is the Timothy hay. So I'll save any hay that isn't wet, because any wet hay can be harmful for them to eat, can upset their tummies. So there's some days where I know people have said, oh, you waste a lot of hay. But if it's soaked, I can't save it. And I like to make sure that everybody has lots of hay so that we don't have teeth problems or digestive issues. So that's why I like to give them a nice big pile. So I gotta change both these pads, because these were flipped this morning, so they're good to go. So I use a cat litter scooper to shake off all the hay. And then this main liner, I gotta go over to the garbage to shake out. So I know that looks like a bunch of hay, but it's soaked. And then some of that stuff they don't eat anyway, like the dark parts. Hi, Reese. Hey, Hucky. Huckle's gonna be 5 next month. Isn't that crazy? So I got Huckle when he was just 4 weeks old. He was born at the rescue at Piggles, Guinea Pig Rescue. They no longer are a rescue, sadly. Hi, Valby. How are you? So, oh, can you believe that? How stupid was that? Well, let's clean this up one more time. Hi, baby. How are you? Okay, let's try this again. So under here we have 2 hay boxes. And the link for our hay box is in the description box. There's a bunch of stuff in the description box for where I buy stuff and everything. And I did make an Amazon wish list to use for gift ideas for family, because all I ever want is things for the guinea pigs. And also, sometimes viewers say that they would love to send us something for the guinea pigs, so there's lots of things on there that the guinea pigs would like, mainly just like food. But hey, guinea pigs love food. So just letting you guys know that's on there. All right. We'll get this back up here. Hi, Bead. So we'll put this back down. And then I'll grab them a fresh pile to put down over here. Excuse me, Ray Ray. I don't want to swap hay on your head. I gotta get in here and vacuum all these tops off. They got so much hay on them. And now I gotta go around to the other side to tidy. Everybody's checking out the new stuff. Okay, so this is the last section to tidy for the herd. I always set up this part of the cage different. This time I went for just some tunnels, just to make it interesting. And then this pad, it's got to be changed. And then they just like to sleep back, hidden behind the tunnels. Wood logs, they're from Amazon, sized large. I think they're Living World. They're my favorite. The pigs do chew on them when they're brand new, but mostly just hide and run through them. Okay, so that's that. So they're good to go, so we're on to the trio. Hi, cuties. Hi, little babies. Where are you going, Buzz? Hi, Autumn. How are you? These guys are so cute. Where's little Annie Banani? Oh, we need a new one. Hey, little Buzzy. How are ya? Annie's back under where the beds are. I see her. There we go. Can you check it out to make sure I didn't miss anything? Hi, Buzz. Will you look too? Make sure it's up to stuff. Hi, little Annie. Put this down, sweetheart. Yep, the sleeping area is always where the most of their poops are. Got stuff that fell down here. Alright. Hey, Bias, are you gonna come out? Let people see you? Hey, come out. Hi, Cindy. No, you're gonna stay back there. We're going back. Okay. Now to the messy part, I bet. Or maybe it's not too bad tonight. We still got lots of hay to save. We'll shake this out. Yep, they need a new one too. Do is check their waters, and then I usually check their pellets, and they're good for the night. Most of the evening they spend eating hay, probably for like a good couple hours or more, and then usually when I'm ready for bed, most of the pigs are in bed and turn off their light.
see it? Hey, sweetie.
Let's give these guys a little bit more orchard grass. Not that they need it. But that's mostly Timothy, so just a little bit of a variety. And that is everything. I think everybody actually looks good for water and pellets. I did most of them this morning. Hey, Reese Bear. Do you want a little bit of the orchard grass? Zoey. Come on over. I didn't mean to startle you. Sorry, Reese dear. You have to go a different way. Come over here. Hello. Hi. How are you? You're so cute. Hello. No! Okay, probably because I bugged you too much already. Alright, have a good night, piggy people.
If you like watching guinea pig videos, learning how to care for us, seeing product hauls or reviews, or really anything else guinea pig, please subscribe and make sure you hit that notification bell so you never miss a video. Down below, I've left two more videos for you to pick from. So keep on watching.